Now, the state elections in Punjab are only 7 months away, and the Akalis are facing 10 years of anti-incumbency and a perception of being responsible for corruption and drugs. But Supir Badal is unperturbed, or so it seems, as Amitoj Singh caught up with the man who could be the next Chief Minister of Punjab.
The man of the moment, in a sense, not just the deputy chief minister, but also the prospective chief minister in the upcoming election in Punjab is with us. Thank you so much, sir, for talking to NDTV. I just wanted to first get an understanding from you about where do you see the elections, where they are right now, a few months away. Where do you see them going when the election day actually comes?
I think people of Punjab are very clear and they're very decisive. Last time also, when the election took place, everyone said, even your channel, that we will that there is a very high anti-incumbency and there will be a clean wipe out of the Akali Dal. Completely opposite happened. Even now, everyone is saying the same thing. And you wait and see, the Akali Dal is going to come stronger again. Akali Dal is not a normal party. It's a 95 years old party with a very strong cadre base.
Okay. Do you acknowledge that the Aam Aadmi Party has made significant inroads in Punjab?
Aam Aadmi Party is a media hype. Like last time, my cousin Manpreet became a media, his party PPP, became a media hype. And everyone saying he's going to win. He lost security deposit, he himself lost, and all the party lost security deposit.
So you think they'll lose money?
They will have been wiped out. I'll tell you frankly, the fight in Punjab is going to be between Akali Dal and Congress.
Aap party
is going to come number three.
All right. We met a lot of people on the road, you know, the youth. They seem to suggest that they want to vote for the Aam Aadmi Party only for the reason that they want to give a fresh party a chance.
See, youth, if you met, did you come for a, we had a youth function the other day.
There's
a youth function, we had a meeting. There were thousands of youth who were for Aam Aadmi Party. Our student organization, SOI, the university elections, Punjab university elections are taking place. Which has got a couple of thousand students from all over Punjab. Okay. Last time also, it's our student organization won hands down. This time again we challenged that you also put up your candidates. So if the youth are with you, they will vote for you. University, Punjab University is basically a sample size.
It's a sample. Okay, the allegation is that the Congress and the Akalis quid pro quo. You scratch my back, I scratch your back. There are allegations of that sort. What do you have to refute that?
I think there's more quid pro quo with the AAP and Congress, because they've been partners together in the previous government in Delhi.
Okay, that's an interesting answer. Right, you talked about a number of things, but the basic factor is the perception. The perception is that you control all the businesses in Punjab, and people who have had private businesses in Punjab, they are leaving Punjab now.
How can I control all the business of Punjab? Do you know something? These are ridiculous questions. I have been the most scrutinized person. The previous Chief Minister, Amrinder Singh, put a full Punjab vigilance against us.
Yes.
Their Congress government put enforcement director against us. Their income tax against us.
But the perception he said
that I want to find everything. They went and checked every of our accounts, every business of mine, and after that, they didn't find a single thing. And the cases against us, which we false cases, were we were acquitted by the courts, not government taking away cases.
Okay.
We are acquitted by the courts. Now, okay. What happens is,
this is
a typical allegation.
People actually believing it. They've been brainwashed by whoever.
There's no brainwash. If they were brainwashed, last time also, Amrinder Singh did the same thing. How did we form the government? People give us votes. Okay. Because people know exactly what is truth and what is wrong.
Okay, at the press conference you talked about ISI and how it is made, he's trying to, you know, disturb the peace of Punjab. But do you think you would concede that your government or your police or your forces have not anticipated that?
No. We have a clearly informed government of India, the complete motive of ISI.
Okay.
Our jurisdiction cannot cross our boundaries. So we have left it to government of India to take appropriate action. I am even saying that even the Aam Aadmi Party, they have very close links with the radical organizations which are destabilizing Punjab and the country. And I'm saying it specifically about
a website, you're saying?
No, not in website. There are so many, they're radical organization members here are 24 hours meeting our leadership, and they're staying with our leaderships and even the function or Sarbat Khalsa, the AAP was supported by AAP.
So what are you saying? Are you saying the Aam Aadmi Party is trying to create a Khalistan?
No. Aam Aadmi Party is doing a dangerous, playing a dangerous game. Just for votes, you should not destabilize this thing. They, like what Congress did, to divide the Sikhs, they created a radical organization. But what happened is that that small organization disturbed the whole state.
Alright, final question about drugs. Unfortunately or fortunately, the rest of India now thinks Punjab is the center of drugs. Mm. How true is that, and how do you defeat that perception within Punjab?
It's a complete false. It's complete false.
6 months back, there was a lot of drugs, but now, because people are aware of it, then the drugs have been kind of, you know, taken out of the air.
No. What does drug mean? One person who takes drugs, obviously, if he takes drugs, he gets addicted to it.
Yes.
Everyone in India has falsely blamed the youth of Punjab, or that 70% of youth are in drugs. So only way to fight it, what we have done is, we are now have a recruitment going on, police recruitment, where approximately 6 lakh youth are going to be tested of drugs. About 1.5 lakh have already been tested, and less than 1% is the total youth found, less than 1%. Even the army at this moment is recruiting to 25,000 youth have been tested by the army also. In 25,000 people tested, youth tested, only 11 or 12 have been found having drugs.
But as I understand, a few months back in Amritsar, there was a drug addiction center opened.
No, the drug addiction centers are opened everywhere.
But
in the country,
you're saying there are no drugs.
No. I'm not saying no drugs.
Okay.
I am saying the way India's government of that whole country has blamed Punjab.
That is
completely. We have less drugs consumption than even Maharashtra or any other state. Okay. If you look at the statistics which are put forward by in Parliament, how many people died of drugs? Okay. Maharashtra became number one with 1500 or 60 people, and Punjab was number 12th.
This Sangat Darshan that you're doing, how responsive has it been for you?
I think this program is very good, because we regularly, by this method, we interact with the common man.
You're getting to know what's in the
what the problems are. And this has been continuously happening in the last 9 years.
Okay,
my father and me.
But you've been doing it in the last few months more than...
No. It's a continuous process of our government for the last 9 years.
Okay.
It has started. My father also does it.
But closer to the election, it seems like you're doing it a bit more.
No, it is... The process is going on.
Okay.
For us, we always prepared for elections.
Okay.
So we have been doing this before, and we're doing it now.
All right. So can we officially say that the Akalis or Sukhbir Badal has sounded the bugle of the war horn, or whatever you want to call it, for the elections?
Akalis are always ready. We are fighters. Akalis are fighters. We are always ready.
What's your message for the Congress and the Aam Aadmi Party?
They have no chance.
Thank you. Appreciate it.